Mr. Taru, in this lesson, we are going to help you deal with some of those problems in your homework involving integration by parts that really take a lot of work. Now, maybe your textbook warned you about these type of problems, and if they probably wouldn't be watching this lesson unless you just want a few more examples. But I've seen some calculus books that don't sort of give you the shortcut method to dealing with some of these integration problems, integration by part problems. You identify U, you identify DV, boom, you're done in like a couple of lines. And there's some that take a few lines, or maybe you have to take a couple of steps of integration by parts to complete the problem. But then it's just some of them you do get to an end, but you know, you have to go with integration by parts 3, 4, 5 times, and that can be like one problem could be just, you know, a whole page worth of work. So if you're realizing that you're going to need to do multiple steps of integration by parts, then a technique called the tic-tac-toe method, which was what they called it in the movie Stand and Deliver, awesome movie if you have not seen it or even heard about it, I'm getting a little old, or something more officially called the tabular method. And when you're going to identify, hopefully, when this technique, there's a couple of names up here, but it's really just one technique, is going to help you streamline your work and get the answer much quicker, you're going to be looking for a factor of your integrand, which is a polynomial. Okay, so our first example, we're doing two in this lesson. If I'm talking too much, you can go to the description and skip to the next one, or well, I'm starting this one now. The indefinite integral of x squared times the sine of 3x dx. Now we're also, with all of my integration by parts lesson, we're letting the LIHATE acronym help us to identify what factor to set equal to u, that factor of our integrand, which of course needs to be simpler when we take its derivative. And do we have any logarithmic functions in our integrand? No. Do we have any inverse trig functions? No. Do we have any algebraic expressions? Why, yes we do, and really that's one of the conditions of us thinking that maybe this tabular method or tic-tac-toe method is going to streamline our integration by parts problem. So and then you have some trig functions and exponential functions. So our algebraic portions of this example, of course, is going to be x squared. The rest of the factors, or the rest of our integrand is going to be our dv. So dv is equal to the sine of 3x dx. And what you want to do, and you're also going to have some sign changes as you go down this tabular method or this tic-tac-toe method. And what we're going to do is, this is sort of like our headers, if you will, of this table that we're going to make. And in the first column, we're going to be taking the derivatives of u until we get down to 0. So the derivative of x squared is going to be 2x. The derivative of 2x, I don't know why I'm pointing up here now, is just going to be 2. And then the derivative of a constant, of course, is going to be 0. And that right there is where you stop. We're going to stop where that column of the derivatives of u becomes 0, and that's going to be the last line of our table that we're going to use to figure out our answer. Now in this third column, we need to integrate dv. So if v is, I don't have any room for scratch work, so I'm going to put it here but then erase it. We have v is going to be equal to the indefinite integral of the sine of 3x dx. Okay, now of course it's pretty simple. Of course, by now I hope to integrate sine, that's going to be negative cosine. The integral of sine is negative cosine, but it's not the integral of sine, it's the integral of the sine of 3x. We have an inside function here. And when I first introduce all this, these basic integration rules, I do a u substitution and I get all the references of x out and replace them with all with u, and I still use that a lot when I do integration. But if it's a fairly simple problem, we can just complete the chain rule pattern so that we can then just integrate without going through a whole u substitution process and removing all the references to x. So our inside function is 3x. The derivative of 3x is equal to 3. Now it means I need to introduce a multiple of 3, and if I'm going to introduce a multiple of 3, then I need to balance that out with a division of 3. So I'm effectively, you know, just multiplying by 1. And now I have the chain rule pattern where it's like this is my outside function, the derivative of my outside function with the original inside function times the derivative of the inside function. And that means that if we have v is equal to 1/3 the definite integral, indefinite integral of 3 sine of 3x dx, then it's also, you know, after the integration process, negative 1/3 cosine of 3x. And so that's going to be the first entry in the second column. Now, at the end of this column, I'm going to indicate that we're going to be sort of multiplying by a positive or a positive 1, if you will. So this is going to be our sign over here. I can just write a circle with the sign of an addition sign in it, or I can maybe like a, I don't want to write a plus 1 because I don't want to make it seem like we're going to be adding 1. We're actually sort of, this is going to be a sign change. We're effectively multiplying by either 1 or negative 1, and that's going to alternate as we work our way down these columns. But just to speed up the video a little bit, let me step off and reveal these next couple lines right now. So we see in the second column that it's dv, and it's in an antiderivative. So we took the antiderivative once, and I just repeated that process a couple of more times. We have our sign changes. Now that first line starts off with sort of a multiple of positive 1, if you will, and it alternates as you go down the list. And you just keep going down again until you get that u giving you a derivative of 0. Now it's kind of cute to say that we're going to do this, you know, what could be a very lengthy problem by just the tic-tac-toe method. It's catchy. I'm not exactly sure what all these the letters tic-tac-toe that are in tic-tac-toe are supposed to actually represent. The only thing that I caution, and you'll see this in the next example, is that I don't think that it's because it's tic-tac-toe that you're necessarily going to have three steps or rows in this table to be able to do the problem. If that were a higher degree, it's going to take more lines. But we're connecting the dots, tic-tac-toe. What are we doing? We're multiplying along these branches. So we're going to have x squared times negative 1/3 cosine of 3x, and it is positive here at the middle, at the end, excuse me, so it's not going to change the negative that's in our middle multiplication. So we're at negative x squared over 3 cosine of 3x, and then we just keep doing that with each of our tic-tac-toes. 2x times negative 1 over 9 is negative 2x over 9, and of course there's sine of 3x there as well, but then we have another multiple of a negative out there, so negative times negative is positive, so we're going to have plus 2x over 9 times the sine of 3x, and then 2 times 1 over 27 is 2 over 27 cosine of 3x, and we're multiplying by positive 1 at the end, and everything's been positive so far, so we have plus 2 over 27 cosine of 3x. Now, at this point, you need to remember, as I'm checking my notes to make sure that I wrote my notes in there, that we are doing indefinite integration. So while there's no plus C's here, we effectively have what could be represented our final answer. So let's make sure we put in our constant of integration. And I've kind of ran out of room, so let me make sure I divide that. And that's an awesome answer, and one that I would highly believe that your teacher is going to be happy with. But if you're checking your answers with a CAS calculator, maybe, or you're checking your answers in a solution guide, that might not be the final answer or version of how your answer looks. As I look at these two terms here, they both have a factor of cosine of 3x. And focusing on this first and third term, we can divide out by some kind of value that's going to cancel out both of those denominators. So, and certainly 3 times 9 is equal to 27. So I can factor out a 1 over 27. And when I do that, we're going to have, let's see, what do we got here in the first term? We have the cosine of 3x is out. We have 1/3 divided by 1 over 27. Remember, I don't know if, you know, I know you're in calculus class. I'm not sure if you really need this now, but when you're factoring out a number, you're dividing out that number, right? So 1/3 divided by, no, there's a negative there. We're going to have a negative. But 1/3 divided by 1 over 27 is 1/3 times 27 over 1, because that division of a fraction is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. And 27 over 3 is going to be equal to 9. So we're going to have negative 9x squared. Now, this is going to be a bit more obvious. If I have a denominator of 27 or 1 over 27 and I factored that out, that's just going to leave us with plus 2. And, of course, our cosine of 3x is out front, and we can't do anything with this last middle term, so we have plus 2x over 9 times the sine of 3x plus c. And that is the end of our first example. Now, we're going to have another example. It's really the same process. I'm just going to put it up here. I'm not even going to read it. I'm just going to put another problem up here, give you about 5 seconds to pause the video and try it on your own just to make sure you have the process nailed down, then reveal the solution one step at a time and make sure that you can do this on your own when you come up to these kind of problems in your homework again. Bye! Alrighty then. So we took the derivative of that right down until we got to zero. And I showed you on the first step of integrating this dv is equal to 2x, just integrating that over and over and over again until we get to that last line where our derivative of u became zero. And then started off our first line with a positive sign, always do that. And then we're alternating those signs as we come down, again, to our last row. And tic-tac-toe. Tick. You know, you got to keep just keep going. It's not three steps. It's going until that u, the derivative of u, comes out to be zero. And then multiplying along all these branches, we get 3x to the third minus 2x times 1/2 e to the 2x minus 9x squared minus 2 times 1 over 4 e to the 2x plus 9 over 4 times x times e to the 2x minus 9 over 8 e to the 2x plus c. Do not forget your integration, constant of integration. Now, looking along all these terms, they all have a factor of e to the 2x. And what I also did is I looked at these denominators and decided, well, that one is well there, and decided that if I pulled out a 1/8, that would, divide out that division of 8, or basically sort of, yeah, that would cancel out all of these denominators. So indeed, 1/2 divided by 1/8 is 1/2 times 8, which is 4. 1/4 divided by 1/8 is 1/4 times 8, which is 2. And same thing here, we have 9 over 4, but that division of 4 getting divided by 1/8 is multiplying by an 8. The 8 divided by 4 is 2. They cancel out, right? And 2 times 9 is equal to 18. And of course, we took that 8 out front. So doing that, we distribute these coefficients of 4, negative 2, combine all our like terms, and we get to a final simplified answer of 1/8 e to the 2x times 12x to the third minus 18x squared plus 10x minus 5 plus c. So hopefully that is what you got if you paused the video and tried this on your own. If not, I hope you can replay it and kind of see where you messed up a little bit. I hope this helped. I'm Mr. Taru. Go do your homework.